Here's where we left off with our coin flipping game. We started out by generating a random number between 0 and 1, and then rounding that number to the nearest integer. So this gave us a number that was either 0 or 1. And then we illustrated our super realistic coin with this ellipse that's either purple or yellow, depending on what the number was. And here's the code where we did that. So we said, if integer is equal to 0, set the fill color to be purple, otherwise set it to yellow. And then we draw the coin down here. But now I've decided that actually my coin has three sides. Yep, a three-sided coin. So let's add that third side. I'm going to start by making a number between 0 and 2. So after we round that, that'll give me an integer that's either 0, 1, or 2. But if we look at our drawing code, we're only accounting for two cases here. So if integer is 0, make it purple, otherwise make it yellow. But now, otherwise could mean either 1 or 2. But wait, what if I did the same thing that we did before, but inside this else block? So I'm just going to say if integer is equal to 1, then set the fill color to be yellow, like it was before. Else, we will set the fill color to be red. Red's pretty good. So what this means is, if integer is equal to 0, set the color to be purple. Otherwise, if it's 1, we will make it yellow. Otherwise, that is, it wasn't 0, it wasn't 1, so it must be 2. We're going to make the color red. If I press restart a bunch of times, it works! Woohoo! So then if I wanted to add more sides to my coin, I could go up here, make this 0 to 3, and then go deeper into this else block and add more if-elses and so on and so forth until I have a bajillion nested blocks. And only then will I realize that this code is disgusting! I mean, gross! Code is supposed to be easy to read and pretty, not as ugly as possible. So here's what we're going to do. Whenever you have just a single if statement or an if-else statement inside an else block, so that means we're not doing anything else outside of these blocks, we're not setting the stroke color, we don't have any more if statements, nothing. All we have is that one if statement and maybe it comes with an else block. Then we can actually combine this condition with the line before and say, else if integer is equal to 1, then set the fill color to yellow. And then this last else block isn't nested anywhere, it just comes at the very end all by itself. Great. So now what this means is, if integer is equal to 0, set the color to purple. Otherwise, if integer is equal to 1, set it to yellow. Otherwise, so if both of these were false, then set it to red. If I press restart a bunch of times, you can see it still works. Great. And the cool thing about this is we can have as many else ifs as we want, which makes it really easy for me to add more sides to my coin. So let's do that now. I'm going to make a number between 0 and 3, and then just add one more else block that says, else if integer is equal to, let's say 2, we'll set the fill color to, well, it was red before, we can keep it red, and then this last else block will be for when an integer is equal to 3, and I'll make that blue. Great! Alright, so in order to do this, you always have to start with an if statement, and then you can have as many else ifs as you want. And then this last guy is optional. We can actually do without it, and then it's possible that all of these will be false, so none of these blocks get executed. But as long as we have that there, then exactly one of these blocks will be run. Cool? Now, this is a case where it doesn't really matter if you say if, else if, else if, else, or just use plain old if statements like we had in the beginning. So if integer is equal to 3. And that's because it's never possible for integer to equal 0 and then also 1, 2, or 3, right? So these conditions are all mutually exclusive. Only one of these blocks will ever get run anyways. But that's not always the case. What if we tried to make a game like this without rounding to an integer? So I'm going to get rid of this part where we round it and the other part where we draw it to the screen. And let's make up some new rules to my game. So I'm still generating a number between 0 and 3, put some more tick marks on our number line. So let's say that if the number falls between 0 and 1, we will make it purple. Wow, that doesn't look like a P at all. You get the idea. Okay, and then if it's between 1 and 2, we can make it yellow. And if it's between 2 and 3, we will make it red. Great, so let's see how we can do that with if and else ifs. So I can start out by saying if number is less than 1. So if it's less than 1, and I know it's between 0 and 3, then it must be in this range. Then I'll set the fill color to be purple. Otherwise, if the number is less than 2, I can set the fill color to be yellow, 255. And otherwise, I'll set the fill to be red. Great. And it works just as intended. So if the number was less than 1, then again, it's in this range. Otherwise, it's greater or equal to 1, but it's also less than 2. So that puts it in this range. So we're going to set the color to yellow. Otherwise, it must be greater than or equal to 2. So it's going to fall in that range. And here's a case where we couldn't just say if number is less than 2 and what would be if number is less than 3. Because if number is less than 1, then it's definitely less than 2. And it's also going to be less than 3. So our coin is always going to end up red. And that's why in this case, it's really helpful to have else if.